This is All India Radio. In the program Surkhiyon Mein, we now bring you Foreign Secretary's special briefing on Prime Minister's visit to the US.
Namaskar. As you are aware, Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi will pay an official working visit to the United States of America from the 22nd to the 25th of September. This will be the Prime Minister's first visit abroad beyond the neighborhood since the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic. Prime Minister will be accompanied by a high-level delegation consisting of the External Affairs Minister, the National Security Advisor, senior officials, including myself. The main elements of the program are bilateral meetings with the U.S. leadership, participation in the Quad Leaders Summit, address at the UN General Assembly, and business interactions. One of the highlights of the visit is the Prime Minister's meeting with the U.S. President, President Joe Biden, in the White House. You are undoubtedly aware that this would be the Prime Minister's first in-person meeting with President Biden as President of the United States of America. The leaders have been in regular contact in recent months. It was in November that the Prime Minister called to congratulate President Biden in his electoral victory. Since then, they've spoken in February and April this year. The Prime Minister has also participated in three major conferences and summits with President Biden as a participant. These were the Quad Leaders Summit in March this year, the Climate Leaders Summit. They also participated in the G7 Summit, which was virtually held. The Prime Minister will participate in the COVID-19 Global Summit as well, hosted by President Biden tomorrow. At their bilateral meeting on the 24th of September, the Prime Minister and President Biden will review the robust and multifaceted India-US bilateral relationship. They will also discuss how the comprehensive strategic global partnership between our two countries can be enriched further. The two leaders are expected to discuss how to bolster bilateral trade and investment ties, strengthen defense and security collaboration, boost strategic clean energy partnership, explore new avenues in emerging technologies, including through R&D, innovation, and industry linkages. The bilateral meeting would also feature current regional security situation following recent developments in Afghanistan, our stakes as a neighbor and a long-standing and preferred development partner of the people of Afghanistan. In this context, we would undoubtedly discuss the need to stem radicalism, extremism, cross-border terrorism, and the dismantling of global terrorist networks. They will also discuss the reform of the multilateral system, including the UN Security Council. The Indian diaspora in the United States, which consists of about 4.2 million people, is a very important factor in the relationship. They play a major role and have been a pillar of support in strengthening the relationship. It is expected that the Prime Minister will highlight the importance of people-to-people ties between the two nations and the potential of enhancing these ties further, especially through higher education linkages and mobility. We appreciate the facilitation that has been provided by the United States in helping Indian students travel to the U.S. for the beginning of their term. The importance of smooth post-COVID travel, especially for students, is also an important factor and is expected to be discussed. Owing to the prevailing COVID situation in the U.S. government has imposed a number of restrictions and limitations on gatherings. The program has been drawn up keeping these constraints and restrictions in mind. The Prime Minister's bilateral engagements include a meeting with Vice President Kamala Harris. This will be the Prime Minister's first formal interaction with the Vice President. It would be recalled that the Prime Minister and Vice President Harris spoke on the telephone in June this year. The Vice President had offered to prioritize India in making U.S. vaccines available in the wake of the COVID situation at that time in India. At their meeting at the White House, the Prime Minister and Vice President Harris are expected to exchange views on bilateral, regional, global issues of mutual interest. The Prime Minister would be having some business-level interactions with the objective of strengthening two-way trade and investments. The U.S. is a very large investor in India. There are a lot of companies that have not only invested significantly in India, but also have the potential to invest either in terms of new investments or expand their existing investments in India. In that context, the Prime Minister will have a few meetings with select CEOs of leading U.S. companies. Now, on the Quad Summit, as I mentioned, this is the first time that there would be an in-person Quad Summit. This will be on the 24th of September, held at the White House. Prime Minister will join Prime Minister Morrison, Prime Minister Suga, and President Biden for the summit. As you would recall, the Prime Minister had participated in the virtual Quad Summit in March, convened by President Biden. This is the first plurilateral engagement of President Biden. It signaled the priority that his administration accorded to the Quad, and it was also the first meeting of Quad leaders, albeit virtually. We see the Quad as a partnership among four like-minded countries in the pursuit of common interests, in striving for a free, open and inclusive Indo-Pacific region. At the summit in March, the leaders had announced a broad array of initiatives, including on vaccines, infrastructure, emerging technologies and climate change. The four leaders will share views and perspectives on the regional situation and the emerging challenges, including in South Asia and the Indo-Pacific region, on how to work together to contain COVID-19, evolve a common approach to emerging technologies and means of addressing climate change. The leaders will take stock of progress made since the March summit, especially in the COVID-19 vaccine partnership. They will identify new areas of cooperation that will reinforce the positive and constructive agenda of the Quad, including contemporary areas that will benefit the Indo-Pacific region as a whole. As you know, the Quad has acquired momentum in the recent past and has been seen as a natural evolution and elevation to the apex level in view of the fact that the four countries share core attributes such as democracy, commitment to pluralism, market-based economic principles. They also have a shared vision of a free and open inclusive Indo-Pacific region. You add prosperity to that as well, and with respect for international law. India's approach to the Indo-Pacific was enunciated by the Prime Minister in his speech at the Shangri-La Dialogue in 2018, when he also expounded on his vision of Sagar, or security and growth for all in the region. On the conclusion of his program in Washington, D.C., the Prime Minister will travel to New York on the 24th of September evening, where he will go in for the third element of his visit at the UN General Assembly. On the 25th of September, Prime Minister will be the first head of state or government to address the United Nations General Assembly at its 76th session. The theme for this year's general debate is, and I quote, building resilience through hope to recover from COVID-19, rebuild sustainability, respond to the needs of the planet, respect the rights of people, and revitalize the United Nations. India is currently a member of the UN Security Council. We held the presidency in the month of August, and we steered the council at a fairly challenging time. While addressing the UN General Assembly, the Prime Minister would dwell on the important issues, including the regional situation, cross-border terrorism, global efforts to combat COVID-19 and climate change, and the need to reform multilateral institutions. The fourth element of the Prime Minister's visit would be bilateral meetings with our close partners, Japan and Australia. The Prime Minister will meet the Australian Prime Minister, Scott Morrison. This is their first meeting in person in the post-pandemic period. The two leaders have maintained a regular dialogue. Just recently, we had our 2+2 dialogue with the Foreign and Defence Ministers of Australia visiting India. The two Prime Ministers are likely to discuss the gamut of India-Australia relations and I think anything that is of mutual interest to both our countries. The Prime Minister will also meet Prime Minister Yoshihide Suga, the Honourable Prime Minister of Japan. This will be their first in-person meeting. They will review progress in the close and multifaceted cooperation between India and Japan under the framework of the India-Japan Special Strategic and Global Partnership and discuss priorities for the future. The Prime Minister's visit with a compact program will bolster India's key strategic bilateral partnership with the United States and our close partners, Australia and Japan. It will also consolidate the Quad as a force for global good and will give the Prime Minister an opportunity to share his vision at the multilateral arena. From the US perspective, we see a strong bipartisan support for a strong relationship with India and strong relationship that can strengthen the global efforts to further our common interests in that regard. We also have very strong trade and economic linkages. In the defense sector, we've had a number of exchanges. We are now preparing for exercise Yudha Abhyas, which is the army level exercises. We are also participating in the Malabar naval exercise, which is underway in Guam with the participation of Australia as well. The visit is also expected to provide momentum. In other words, would provide direction to some of the important bilateral mechanisms that we have, whether it's the trade policy group, whether it's a defense policy group or the trade policy forum, or a number of other mechanisms that are now ready to review that relationship in those areas. I think once this summit is over, we will have the opportunity to take them forward. Finally, let us summarize how we see the overall visit. India and the US are both vibrant, mature democracies. We share common values, including the rule of law, equality, freedom, and pluralism. We are both free market economies with proactive shareholders in global issues, committed to global prosperity, peace, and security. The upcoming visit of the Prime Minister would not only enhance peace, depth and diversity of our bilateral relations, it would also give an opportunity to further strengthen comprehensive global strategic partnership on issues of mutual concern.
You were listening to Foreign Secretary's special briefing on Prime Minister's visit to the US. You can listen to it on our mobile app News on AIR. This program is also available on our YouTube channel News on AIR Official.